What's going on, guys, and welcome to Ghost Recon Wildlands. It feels like it's been a really long time since the open beta. It just wrapped up last week. It's crazy. It's been like the longest week of waiting for a video game to come out, but finally, it is launch day, and I'm excited. Thank you for clicking on this video. Thank you for embarking on this initial journey with me. Hope you stick around for the entire walkthrough. We're going to spend a majority of this first video going through a lot of the stuff that happened in the closed beta. So we're going to try to get through the entire Yuri and Polito storyline. I can't make any promises. That might be a little too long, but I will try my best. But that is it for me, guys. Thank you for tuning in. Let's go. All right, so we'll start out with character customization. This is pretty much going to be the same thing I did in the beta. I got a good look pretty much laid out. I think I'm going to go, was it Rock or Beetle? It was Beetle. And a couple of costumes. We've got the Yeti Hunter. We've got the Rebel Leader. And we've got the Dying Earth. Where is the Hunter outfit? Special outfits. Or the Huntsman. Whatever that was called. Should have been something I had already, but apparently I don't have it. But feeling pretty good with how this looks so far. Let's hop into the game. Let's go. Alright, one more thing I keep forgetting about this. I do want to play most of this on extreme, because a lot of I like a lot of the HUD options on extreme, but I'm going to do this on advanced, because I don't trust the AI, my teammates, in this game. Sorry, can't do it.
The agent they murdered. You knew him?
He was a friend of mine.
Sorry for your loss.
I could say it comes with a job, but it doesn't get any easier.
No, it doesn't. Guess you've been down here a while?
I've been living as Karen Bowman, international aid worker, for just about 5 years. Means living rough, but as a cover, it gets me out and about.
At least it comes with a chopper.
How'd you get in country? I flew in business class from Manaus. Hey, I'm refreshed and ready for work, right? I just hitched rides from Barranco, Peru. How about you?
I got on board a bus in Huy, Argentina, and drank all the way to Villazón. Nobody wants to deal with a drunk on the bus.
That explains why you smell like ash.
I've heard rumors about you guys. I was a rookie field officer in Moscow when the coup went down. There was talk you were involved?
Nah, it must have been someone else. We were never there.
It's not every day you get to meet an urban legend in the flesh.
Huh, you should tell that to my kid. Maybe he'd listen when I tell him to take the trash out.
Is it hard being someone who doesn't officially exist?
You tell me, Karen Bowman, international aid worker.
I'm sure you've seen the horrible, fucked up shit humans are capable of when there are zero repercussions. But let me tell you right now, no matter how you compartmentalize, how you desensitize, you can't prepare for El Sueño. He's got a religious streak that rates pretty close to delusional. He's taken vows of poverty, chastity. If he's not in it for the chocha or the money, he's in it for the power. This joint task force is CIA, DEA, and JSOC. I'm your resident spook for this ride. Welcome to Operation Kingslayer.
Our briefing said there'd be a contingent of locals.
The Qatar is 26. They're a group of rebels who've been giving Unidad and Santa Blanca some resistance. We'll meet their leader, Pat Qatari, soon as we touch down. Bolivians have a long history of hating us Yankees, but this time, let's hope the enemy of my enemy will be my friend. But don't turn your back on him. I'm not going to.
Thank you.
your soldiers. This is the help you promised, that Sandoval promised. A single Yankee died, so you send a handful of soldiers. Hundreds of Bolivians have died from Santa Blanca's bullets. Where will my hundreds of soldiers come from?
As Americans, we aren't here, remember? These soldiers are the best covert ops team our country has to offer. With their help, you won't need hundreds of soldiers.
Are you familiar with the word Huber, Senora Bowman?
Meet Pak Atari, leader of the resistance group Qataris 26. We will be working with the rebels to destabilize Santa Blanca's organization. They've been fighting Santa Blanca and corrupt Bolivian officials for nearly 6 years now. We'll need to coordinate targets.
There is no time for this. We have information on Amaru's whereabouts.
Amaru? You found him? Amaru is one of the founders of the Qataris 26.
More than that, her group is founded on his ideas. Without his theories of an agrarian proletariat, there would be no organized resistance against Santa Blanca and the corruption in our government. Amaru must be saved. If you were to assist my people, it would do much to earn my confidence.
Where is he?
We do not know exactly. We know he's in this province and that there is a Santa Blanca lieutenant who knows where he is.
I'll put a call into the activity, see if they can dig more intel out of the airwaves. Start looking for that lieutenant and keep me informed of everything via sat phone. Good hunting.
Saving Amaru is important to our cause, Yankee. Make sure you don't kill the Santa Blanca lieutenant before you get the chance to ask him questions.
Alright guys, so that is an interesting start. Welcome officially to Ghost Recon Wildlands. Looking good. I mean, obviously there's the lip syncing to the audio still a little off. There's a little bit of issues with the software or whatever. Everything here is pretty much the same. Got a full attack map. Let's take a look and see exactly what I'm getting into here. So we've got this one star area or one difficulty area. We had Montauk in the closed or the open beta. This is a 5 difficulty. And a couple of the areas around, we've got a 3 below us. There's a 4 to the bottom right. Is there another 1? There's a 2. There's a 3. There's a 4. All right, so there's only one difficulty area over here. There's a couple of 2s, but that's about it. This is as easy as it gets. So if we can't get through this, we're screwed.
Time to earn your pay, people. Put on your game faces.
I tell you, I'm not too comfortable working with Pak Atari and these rebels. Their kind of ideology always ends up with more bodies in the ground. What's your feeling on this op, Nomad?
End of the day, this is a revenge mission. We need to focus and get this done quick before we get stuck between local politics and the firestorm of cartel bullets. First objective, track down that Santa Blanca lieutenant so we can find Amaru.
Whoa.
Right, I'm gonna try to not fly us off the road here. I've been known to do that before. But I'm looking good. Frames are holding pretty steady. They could be better. I had better performance, I think, in the beta than I did, than I'm having right now, which is kind of weird. But they haven't put the NVIDIA drivers out for this yet, so I'm hoping those will get some of these issues fixed. Hopefully. You never know. It's all been done before. This is why I want to get through most of this stuff now. In this first episode, that way we can do some of the new stuff that I didn't show in later episodes.
What do you think El Sueño was like as a kid? Probably pulled the wings off flies.
Burned ants with a magnifying glass.
Tied cats over clotheslines. Maybe he had a cocaine stain. Junior achievement.
Who knows? Maybe he played violent video games.
I don't believe that shit, that video games make people violent. So what does make people violent then? Other people.
Alright, so let's get a move on. Let's start coming up to this position. I turned tutorials off, so they shouldn't be hitting me with these tutorials. I know what to do here.
That's a kill.
Oh, didn't want to do that. Wrong button. Meant to put this in semi-auto. Alright, one thing I do want to check really quickly. I messed with the HUD options before and apparently they didn't save. We're gonna take crosshair's off. I don't know why this reverted back on. This is fine. This is fine. This is fine. Input reminders are fine. Minimaps fine. Markers are fine. Mission reminders are fine. Hints. Let's turn these off. Team info off as well. One thing I wish they did, and I don't know why they don't have an option under this, but you guys see, like, we have this heat marking. If you look at the area on the minimap here, this shows there's enemies over here that you haven't marked yet. I wish they got rid of that, or there's an option to turn that off outside of extreme. Because in extreme, by default, it's off. But for some reason...
Let's move.
God, oh my gosh, the stuttering. When you come out out of the menu... Very bad.
I need you there.
Roger.
This game is good, but oh my gosh, the frames new. What is going on?
Targets confirmed. Ready to assault.
Got another tango.
Moving to position. Targets marked. Just say the word. Say the word.
Target down.
Okay, the frames, I'm getting a little frustrated. Right now, this is not good. This is going to make for a very frustrating first episode. Oh my gosh. First walkthrough on PC, and I'm playing probably the most unoptimized game I've ever played in my life. This is not good. Where is this? Oh, it's up here.
Sicario over here.
I don't see him.
There, in the watchtower.
I see a second target.
And I still can't mark people by just... I have to actually aim.
Ready. Call the shot.
You guys can take that.
Tango down.
Go.
So my goal for this walkthrough... I don't know. I kind of want to play this very... stealthily, where I'm not killing people, but at the same time, that's not going to be possible most of the time. So we're going to try to. We're going to play it stealthy, but we're going to kill people at the same time. Oh my gosh, that sounds so horrible. But we're going to have to drop people. People are going to have to get dropped in order for us to do what we need to do. In order for the ghosts to achieve their mission, people are going to have to die.
Tangos are marked. What's the word?
You guys can drop that guy.
Ready to engage. That tango's down.
All right, time to grab this lieutenant.
Easy, Camine.
Pinche cabrón. That's close.
I need you there.
And let's interrogate.
Here's the deal, asshole. You answer my questions, or I put a bullet in your gut and leave you to die in your own shit. Lo entiendes?
Chill the fuck out, cabrón. What do you want?
Amaru. Where can I find him?
You serious? That's what this is about? Sure thing. He's at Atoya Farm. Go on. Then you can see what we do to people who fuck with us. People like you.
We need to get this done in a hurry. Amaru's an old man. He's not gonna last long under torture.
Shit, if they've been working on him for a while, there's a good chance he's already dead. Maybe, maybe not. Amaru is a major player in the rebel movement. The cartel will keep him alive as long as they can to find out what he knows.
We can't afford to take any chances. There's too much riding on this. Let's move.
I miss my TAR-21 and my HTI sniper rifle. Oh man, we gotta get to Montauk ASAP. Alright, so we got all four guys marked. They can have that guy. Try and get that first upgrade.
Cartel isn't going to wait around for us to track down and rescue Amaru.
Fuck, tango down.
How are you not dead? That's a headshot. Hello. What? Really?
Frag out. Come in here, culeros.
Dude, is this guy invincible? I can't kill this guy. I can't do it. Oh my gosh. Oh, they got him. Oh, what the hell? Apparently my aim sucks. Apparently my aim sucks. Alright, let's get out of here. That was a little frustrating. Actually, we're gonna take one of those cars. Just have them wait over there. Let's grab these supplies really quick. I didn't bother to do this too much during a beta, but you need to grab these supplies early on because the first couple upgrades you're going to need are going to be for the drone, and you're going to need, let's just take a look at that really quick actually. Let's look at skills. So the drone, you're going to need battery, which is going to require fuel, and then you also need range, which is going to require the good old medicine. So those are going to be two pretty useful things to have. Night vision's also something you could get. It's not necessarily, I don't think it's needed initially. But this should hopefully, this collectible should put us over the hump for the first upgrade.
El Sueño, the Sicarios have found the escaped prisoner in the village of Culta. What a wonderful name for a town. They were protecting him.
Si. The village is known to Unidad as a haven for rebels.
Why do these rebels even bother? Kill them all. The whole village. Visit divine wrath upon Culta. And wipe it off the face of the earth.
Claro. Al rato.
Wow, that's messed up.
You fuckers trying to lose me? Closing.
This is... Look at this, man. Look at the draw... Oh my gosh. Playing this 1440p. This is ultra. This is maxed out. I don't know how good I'm going to get the quality to go to YouTube. Because obviously compression and all that stuff. But this is sexy.
These Vatos Locos make me miss the Taliban.
It's the coke. They're all jacked up.
Hey, you work at a bar, you're gonna drink the beer.
When you hit them, they don't feel it. They just keep coming.
You tap them in the head, it don't matter what they feel.
And they got better aim than the Taliban.
But all these assholes, they all got a fetish for lopping off heads. What's that shit about?
Alright, we're gonna try to get in here and get out of here stealthily. Because when I played this, I played the closed beta on Xbox, and I got through this pretty good, but pretty well. But when I played this on PC, it was a mess because I didn't know the control. So I was trying to go prone, and I was standing up. I was trying to crouch, and I was pulling out the drone. I meant that the other way around. But yeah, the controls, I was still getting used to it.
Target down.
All right, let's get across the street here.
Move there.
Copy that.
And we should be able to get in there pretty cleanly. What is this? Supplies? Nice. Food parcels. Is that a... Nope, it's not an enemy. All right, let's keep moving. Actually, let's just have them regroup.
Rally up, people.
Copy.
So we get where we need to go. God rays are maxed out. Man, this game looks good. Say what you will about the gameplay. This is Ubisoft's best looking game. I don't care what anybody says. I'm confused. What road? Oh wait, no, we pull up a road short. Okay, because that patrol on the side of the road, that's not normally there. So we pulled up a little short of where we normally do. So we would have been on that street right there.
Up. We got hostiles in the area.
I got a narco
there.
There, in the barn. Roger.
Alright, so I'm going to try to do a little bit of marking here. Just to make sure I can get in and out of here cleanly.
Got another tango. I got a third target.
It's a scarecrow. It's a guy. There's normally... There's a guy inside. Did they already mark this guy?
Tango marked, but he's got a civilian nearby.
Just one more guy. There he is. Okay, cool. So everyone's marked. So this should be pretty simple. This is just timing your shots, getting in, getting out, not doing anything stupid. I gotta rebind these keys, because the crouch being control and prone being C is very, very backwards. Not a huge fan of it. So one thing I'm wondering, did they upgrade the intelligence? Because you could actually shoot an enemy And he'd be laying on the floor, and if no one saw him got shot, they could walk over that guy and not care that he's dead. So I'm a little questioning. I'm a little worried here about actually shooting anyone, because I don't know what improvements they made.
A lot of these Sicarios are ex-military.
ID your targets. If Amaru gets killed by a stray round, Operation Kingslayer will be dead in the water before it even starts. Let's go.
All right, we're going to drop this guy. Come on, guys. Mark him. You see him. You see him. There we go. All right, so he's dead. His body... Oh, wait, there's a guy... Hold on, where is this guy? Oh, there's a guy right here. Holy moly, I did not see this guy. Stop calling your baby mama. She don't want to hear about your problems. She don't want to talk to you about her day or your day. She had better things to do. All right, so that's two guys down. So we pretty much got a chance, or I've got a chance. I'm going to leave these guys back here. I've got a chance to kind of just sneak in here. Although I do want to drop this guy. Oh, you guys are ready already. Nice. And box dropped. All right, so let's actually get ready to move this way. I could probably... No, you know what? No, I'm not going to do that. Could I put them in this courtyard or this grass area? Crap, wrong button. I hate when I do this. Crouch. And they can see you through this grass. Sometimes I'm going to try to stay behind. And see, there should be two bodies on the ground. And, oh, they disappeared. Oh, they're still doing that? No, that's... Alright, you're going to die. I kind of want to shoot this guy. But then again, I probably missed. Although, there is a guy in this building I'm a little worried about hearing this shot. So I'm going to try to see if I can melee this guy. As long as no one else comes around that corner. I don't want to get too close. Because if I crouch, he's going to end up seeing me before I can snap in the cover. Someone should be able to drop it. I'm going to drop this guy.
He's history.
All right, you didn't hear that. Good. All right, one more guy. Hold still. Is that guy inside or is he outside? I don't know where he is. All right, technically, I should be able to get in and out of here without anybody seeing anything. You know, I'm going to have them... Oh, you guys are going to have to drop that guy before he turns around.
Say the word.
All right, he's down.
Hold up. There's a weapons case here.
All right, let me grab this really quick.
This will go nice with my boots.
Panoramic sight. Oh, you know what I didn't do? I meant to put the other iron sights on.
Tango down.
Alright, we're just gonna kill everybody. We're just gonna take the chopper out of here. I didn't kill everybody last time I did this, but this is just too easy. Alright.
Clear on my side.
Are you Amaru? What's left of him anyway? Come on, we're getting you out of here. Go.
Copy that.
All right, so pretty easy introduction. Could have been a little stealthier. But why be patient when you can just kill everyone? Who cares? All right, so let me go ahead. Let me mess with this really quick because I do want to change. Wait, where are the other? Wasn't there another iron sight for this? Oh, right. Wrong weapon. That's why. Okay, let's do this one. Parts. Stock. I could have sworn. Am I not looking at... why does it keep going back to the MP5? Can we do this one, please? Can we do this? Edit. Oh my gosh. Okay. Gotta double click on it. Scope. There we go. Polymer. Backup iron sights. Alright, cool. We'll go with those. I'm not a huge fan of that red dot. I'll put that on the MP5 now that we can finally actually go to click on this one. That was a little frustrating. Alright, so let's get out of here.
Roger that.
I'll pilot.
Little wide. And the, oh my gosh, whoa, that could have been bad. Can we stop with the stuttering? Perfect landing. Alright, we'll grab this M48-5, swap this out really quick. And now I can actually use this M48-5 with a different scope, because that was a little frustrating. Actually, let's take a look at the weapons really quick. So we do have this shotgun. Super shoddy, we get an Itakua. I know that we got some other stuff. The SASG Agua Verde. Where is the SCAR H? That's what I really want. SR-25 I could really use. LED-582, G-28, Mark 48, MPX would be nice. The R5 and Montepunku, or Punku, or whatever, M4A1, TAR-21s and Montauk. Mark 17, Flor de Or. Or unlock in the store. Whatever. Where's Flor de Or? Alright, what? Why can I see the other? Oh, there we go. Alright, Flor de Or. It's a 5. Oh my gosh. It's a 5. We gotta go down. Okay, we're probably gonna do that. I don't know. We're gonna try to see if we can get some of this, the better weapons. But this is a security area. It's gonna be a little tough. Let's talk to Karen.
Are you hurt?
Santa Blanca is not the most gracious of hosts. These Aucas, these demons, they had questioning me. Let us say, their talk of love was enough to make me vomit. But their methods were not...
Were their names Yuri and Polito?
Si. Yuri and Polito.
These are the fucks that tortured Ricky Sandoval while Sueño questioned him. I want them bad.
We only saw run-of-the-mill Sicarios when we freed Amaru.
But I haven't seen Yuri and Polito in at least 3 days, maybe 4. I don't know where they are now.
We need more intel.
We'll search every village and camp until we find something.
Somebody's gotta know something. Gather documents, hack computers, interrogate hostile lieutenants, talk to civvies, whatever it takes.
We'll turn over every rock.
Let's go, Ghost! Alright, and Uplay rewards. Plus 20 Uplay points.
Heads up, Bowman's file on Yuri and Polito is coming through.
Estamos con ustedes.
There were 4 people in the room the night DEA agent Ricky Sandoval was murdered. El Sueño, the head of the Santa Blanca cartel, Ricky, and the last 2 were La Yuri and El Polito. Yuri and Polito met at a poor state-run hospital in Chiapas, where El Polito was doing his residency and La Yuri worked as a nurse. It was love at first sight. From the first moment their eyes met, they were inseparable. A love like no other. One day, a buchon named La Plaga walked into the ER, all shot up. It was touch and go for a while, but Yuri and Polito were able to save his life. La Plaga was grateful. He showered them with gifts, invitations to the most exclusive parties, even a new car. And after a while, La Plaga made Yuri and Polito the personal medical staff of the Santa Blanca cartel. But that wasn't their main job. See, Yuri and Polito know about the human body. They know how much pain a person can endure before he'll die. They know how to keep a person alive and awake so they can feel the pain. And most of all, they know how to inflict that pain. That's what they do in Itaqua province. When Santa Blanca captures someone that refuses to talk, La Yuri and El Polito make them talk. They break people. Like I said, there were four people in the room the night Ricky Sandoval was murdered. Sueño, Ricky, Yuri, and Polito. They kept Ricky alive while Sueño tortured him. Non-stop for 47 hours straight. They broke Ricky Sandoval. Then Sueño executed him.
That's the rundown on La Yuri and El Polito. They're a key part of Santa Blanca's security operation. Remember to check out Bowman's briefing on their chain of command.
Guy in charge of security is El Muro, the Wall. Personal bodyguard and childhood friend to El Sueño. El Muro's little brother is La Plaga. Nasty piece of shit. Very active on social media. Head sicario for the cartel.
The hunt starts now. We want Sueño, we gotta work our way up the hierarchy. First targets are Yuri and Polito. We find the intel, we track them down, we take them out.
Alright guys, so that's going to do it for the first episode for Ghost Recon Wildlands. I wanted to get through more, but I didn't want to upload like an hour and a half video. Let's keep these moderately length. So we're probably going to do, this one's probably going to be around 35-40 minutes. And then the other ones will probably sit around 25-30 on average. And we'll try to keep that fair. But thank you all for tuning in. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, make sure you hit the like button. Also, subscribe so you're notified when new videos come out. That lady is freaking out. Just try to walk away, lady. But thanks for tuning in, guys. Hope you enjoyed. See you next time.